This is the Savage Nation. I got this today from the internet. Someone sent it to me. High school, 1959 versus 2009. Scenario one. Jack goes quail hunting before school and then pulls into the school parking lot with a shotgun in his truck's gun rack. 1959, vice principal comes over, looks at Jack's shotgun, goes to his car and gets his shotgun to show Jack. 2009, school goes into lockdown, FBI call, Jack hauled off to jail, never sees his truck or gun again. Counselors called in for traumatized students and teachers. Scenario two, high school 1959 versus high school 2009. Johnny and Mark get into a fist fight after school. 1959, crowds gather. Mark wins. Johnny and Mark shake hands and end up buddies. 2009, police call and SWAT team arrives. They arrest both Johnny and Mark, and they are both charged with assault. Both expelled, even though Johnny started it. Scenario three. Jeffrey will not sit still in class. He disrupts other students. 1959, Jeffrey sent to the principal's office and given a good paddling by the principal. He then returns to class, sits still, and does not disrupt class again. 2009, Jeffrey is given huge doses of Ritalin. He becomes a zombie. He is then tested for ADD. The school gets extra money from the state because Jeffrey has a disability. Scenario four, Billy breaks a window in his neighbor's car, and his dad gives him a whipping with his belt. 1959, Billy is more careful next time, grows up normal, goes to college, and becomes a successful man. 2009, Billy's dad is arrested for child abuse. Billy is removed to foster care and joins a gang. The state psychologist is told by Billy's sister that she remembers being abused herself, and their dad goes to prison. Billy's mom has an affair with the psychologist. That's the world I'm from.
Savage.
Go back to high school 1959 versus high school 2009. Scenario five, Mark gets a headache and takes some aspirin to school. In 1959, Mark shares his aspirin with the principal out on the smoking dock. In 2009, the police are called and Mark is expelled from school for drug violations. His car is then searched for drugs and weapons. Scenario six, Pedro fails high school English. In 1959, Pedro goes to summer school, passes English, and goes to college. In 2009, Pedro's course is taken up by state. Newspaper articles appear nationally explaining that teaching English as a requirement for graduation is racist. The ACLU files class action lawsuit against the state school system and Pedro's English teacher. English is then banned from core curriculum. Pedro is given his diploma anyway, but ends up mowing lawns for a living because he cannot speak English. Scenario 7. Johnny takes apart leftover firecrackers from the 4th of July, puts them in a model airplane paint bottle, and blows up a red ant bed. In 1959, ants die. In 2009, ATF, Homeland Security, and the FBI are all called. Johnny is charged with domestic terrorism. The FBI investigates his parents, and all siblings are removed from their home, and all computers are confiscated. Johnny's dad is placed on a terror watch list and is never allowed to lie again. Scenario 8. Comparing 59 to 2009 in a high school. Johnny falls while running during recess and scrapes his knee. He is found crying by his teacher, Mary. Mary hugs him to comfort him. 1959, in a short time, Johnny feels better and goes on playing. 2009, Mary, the teacher, is accused of being a sexual predator and loses her job. She faces 3 years in state prison. Johnny undergoes 5 years of therapy. Now you understand where I'm coming from, right? I mean, my world was shaped then, not now, and I'm proud of it. And I really don't care what you think of me. And there's more of me than there are of you. Make no mistake about it. Yeah, you think there are more of you because you schmucks have idiots like you in the newspaper business and on television. And you have all the men without private parts telling you that you want to hear the kind of garbage you want to hear. But this is what most Americans think, whether they were born 15 years ago or 60 years ago, by the way. They don't think like you do, you left-wing schmucks. And let me tell you something again. I'm going to say it until you hear me. If the election were held again today, even Schmuck McCain would win by 15 points. There is such voters' remorse in this country from this fraud artist that you can't believe it. Play some heavy metal right now.